Hello and welcome. I'm Peggy. I thank you for letting us share a part of your day, and I hope that you'll take time to really sit down and listen and watch. We have people here, we're talking about life and death issues on our highways, and we have some of the worst, most dangerous roads in the United States of America, right here in the Southeast and in South Carolina. And we have two experts here. They're going to talk to us. And if you're a parent and you have kids, teenagers, all of this information, we're not here to beat up on anybody or make somebody feel guilty. We're here to try to present common sense facts that together we can save lives and make our roads safer. And especially if you have teenagers at home. We need to know the facts. And I'm so pleased. Kelly Stafford is here. Kelly is the Victim Services Specialist for the Upstate. And Jennifer Colby, and she is a Court Monitoring Specialist. And they're here on behalf of MAD, Mothers Against Drunk Driving. Okay? And I guess I have to be, I don't even want to be nice, because my husband and I have been the victims of a head-on collision where the driver was drunk. And if you have experienced something like that, you never, ever forget. And I'm here to try to save lives, to try to help parents talk to their teenagers. And we just, you know, and if nobody's judging, if you're someplace and people are drinking and you drink, if you're over 21 or whatever, you're not breaking the law. But get somebody to drive who isn't drinking. And if you have teenagers at home, sit down and talk to them, because it could be their life, right?
Yes, sure.
Okay, can. Now I'll get off my soapbox, but this is something I feel passionately about.
Sure, because you've been involved in a crash.
And once you have witnessed and or survived something like that, it never leaves you.
No, it doesn't. Specifically, if the crash involves the loss of a loved one.
Well, thank God ours did not.
Exactly.
But it happened a long time ago. But
you still remember it, and you're still passionate about
it. And you still have to say, well, why would somebody drink and get in the car and drive? Why?
I think people feel that they can still drive. I feel like people think when they drink, they feel like, I'm sober enough. I can drive. I'm okay. I'm not going to hurt anyone. And everybody thinks it can't happen to them. And I think that's the reason they still get behind the wheels. They think it'll never happen to them. But unfortunately, we see it every day that it does happen to people. People who never, you would never expect it to happen to. They kill innocent people every day.
Yeah.
And I think it's a sense of an invincibility in the younger generation. They're
going to
live. Yes,
they feel like the world is their oyster.
That's right. And so it becomes, I think, also some peer pressure. You know, it's not cool to hand the keys to somebody else. I'm good. I can drive. I'm fine. And they don't realize that split second decision could be the biggest mistake of your life. You could get in the car, kill someone, or injure someone, and you could end up in prison potentially for the rest of your life, or you have to live with the fact that you took another person's life, and you're trying to deal with that at 16, 17, 18 years old. So it creates a lifelong problem for not just the perpetrator, but also the victims forever.
Now, you're both here on behalf of MAD.
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm.
And can anybody, what does MAD require? Do you have to join? Do you have to tell us about it?
You are welcome to volunteer with MAD. We always look for volunteers. Yes. We want volunteers. Many people do come to MAD because they were victims in a DUI crash. Whether they survived or they lost a loved one, that's how we get a lot of our volunteers.
I'll bet.
But we, you know, just as a community, this is a huge public health issue. So anybody who's concerned about the issues of that, whether they've been involved in a crash or not, we welcome you to join us. It is free. All you have to do is is go onto our website, www.mad.org/South Carolina SC, and you can fill out to volunteer. We have many, places for you in MAD.
And it doesn't cost money to join MAD.
It does not cost money, no, ma'am. Mm-mm. So we always have a place for you at MAD, regardless of how you want to help. There's something you can do to help.
Well, do you have regular meetings or?
We actually have, because we cover the entire state of South Carolina.
Oh, boy.
We have chapters throughout the state.
Okay.
In various counties.
Yeah.
So yes, there's probably a MAD chapter somewhere near where you live within South Carolina. We do have a chapter here in Greenville as well as in Spartanburg as well.
I've got to ask the loaded question. They say that South Carolina, our roads are some of the most dangerous in the nation.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that's true or not.
It is.
It is. Okay.
It is.
That being said, you have to say why. We are the Bible Belt.
Mm-hmm.
We're here,
yeah,
in the part of the country that is conservative, mm-hmm, more than other places. Why is it? Do you have any answer for that?
I wish I had an answer. Part of my job and my position as court monitoring is to observe DUI cases in the courtrooms, take down information, what is happening when people are coming to court with a DUI charge. And the goal in doing that is to sit down at the end of the year and get all our numbers together and meet with judges, solicitors, defense attorneys, police officers, so that we can work together to come up with a solution. I so many times ask myself, why is this such a huge problem here? Don't drink and drive seems very simple, but for some reason, people are not getting that message. I don't understand.
And I feel like our laws in South Carolina are very weak compared to other states.
All right, now how explain what you mean by that.
Sure, our penalties are not as stiff as some of the other states for drinking and driving. DUI first offense is generally, you can receive up to 30 days, but it's very rare that you see someone actually receive 30 days for DUI first. Generally, they'll get a fine and perhaps they'll get some alcohol and drug counseling, but that's generally it for DUI first. A lot of times, because our laws, because there's a loophole in our video tape law, which is where the officers have to actually videotape your field sobriety test when they've pulled you over for a possible,
yeah,
drunk driving. If for some reason your foot is out of the video, if for some reason the officer stands in front of the offender while they're doing their test, it can get thrown out of court per the law. And, you know, not all judges do this, but a good many do. And so a lot of our DUIs that are brought to court are actually dropped or pled down,
yeah,
to lower charges like,
yes,
reckless driving. So this may be your first time getting pulled over with DUI. You plead a reckless driving. So the next time it happens, well, it's DUI first again. So it's, you're not,
oh,
getting,
yes,
the actual, you know, the actual amount. And they say people will drive 80 times drunk before they actually get arrested the first time. So this is definitely not their first time doing it when they're arrested.
Now you are involved. What do you say to, what do you say to parents who have teenagers? How can we help these kids to realize? Because when you're young, you think nothing,
right,
bad's ever going to happen to you. We've all been young. You
exactly
remember that wonderful feeling.
Yes.
What can parents do to help solve the problem with their kids?
You've got to talk to your children. I think the biggest mistake that a parent can make, especially when it comes to the issue of alcohol, is acting like it's no big deal. All kids do that.
Well, that's what they'll say.
Sure.
You know, everybody's doing it.
But guess what? There are people who die. There are kids who die. You cannot send your child off to college and say, oh, it's okay for them to drink. All the other 18-year-olds are doing it. Well, maybe, but it could be your 18-year-old that's wrapped around a tree,
mm-hmm,
or goes into a coma or becomes brain dead. You've got to leave the lines of communication open and let your children know that drinking under the age of 21 is not acceptable. It is not going to be acceptable in your family. It's obviously not acceptable under the law. And we've got to hold our children accountable for their actions. And that becomes a big issue.
And MAD does a power of parents group. Basically, what it is
we can. What is that? I've heard about the power of parents. What is that?
That's basically where MAD can come out to your church, your school, any community group that you have, and we can give a power of parents presentation. And it's basically giving parents the guidelines that they need to talk to their children about alcohol and making this a conversation that's comfortable to have with parents and children, letting them know that it's okay to tell your child you can't drink. It's unacceptable under the age of 21 to drink, not only for, you know, driving, but because it can, you know, it can stunt your brain development. It can, you know, cause you to be in a coma depending if you drink too much. There's various reasons that, you know, people under the age of 21 do not need to drink, and Power of Parents actually gets with parents and helps them have that conversation with the child. It's a free presentation, and you're welcome to call Matt and we'll come do it for you anytime.
That's wonderful. So you would do that to parents groups, school groups, Sunday school groups, anybody that
absolutely
where there are parents.
Yes. Anybody that asks, yes, ma'am.
I didn't even know that you did that.
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
So now you've got the power of parents. What about this power of teens or the power of youth? What is that?
The power of youth goes into the schools. A lot of times we're called around prom season, we can go anytime. And basically, it's an education on for teens to stand up to the bullying that they may receive for not drinking, or the peer pressure that they may receive to drink alcohol. And so it basically goes in and teaches teens that it's okay to say no. It's okay, you know, not to go hang with the crowd that's drinking. And it gives them some tools that they may need to stand up to it, to stand up to their friends and stand up to peer pressure.
Now, do they go into schools or whatever and...
Yes.
Do you have to request?
Yes, schools can call and request us. We do middle schools and high schools. They're welcome to call our office anywhere in the state. You're welcome to call, and we do have people that will go out and give these presentations again for free to the students of the school.
That's wonderful.
Yes.
And you go other places other than schools?
Yes, if there's a group of children, say at a church or you know somewhere else, we'll be glad to do it for them as well.
All right, and you simply would call MAD, and we'll have a phone number. We're going to go to a quick break. We'll have a phone number when we come back, okay?